these are some of the businesses which are in fashion these days. Fashion, I mean, you've heard them a lot. Organic foods, tourism, medical tourism, online platforms, so many online brand retail shops. Then you have the online transporters. There's something called the helpingdoc.com, which is too much on FM these days. Then you have the online health facilities. You have those fitness brands, which are setting up across Delhi NCR. You have the printing marketplace, which is there online as well as offline. Just go around, shop and come back. You have the fast food joints. A lot of them are entrepreneurial ventures. And they are doing pretty good. So what do we mean when we talk about sustainability? Anything which is sustainable has to be concentrated around the employees, has to be concentrated around the business owners, as well as the shareholders. And it is, of course, the responsibility of every business owner to ensure that it becomes a legal entity so that it outlives the founder. But the trouble is that almost 90% of the startups fail. And the basic reason is, of course, lack of good planning and the lack of being able to put them in a legal framework. What it takes to start a business in India. There are around 12 procedures, takes about 27 days. We consider here that you pay no bribe. So most of the things are online now. The cost is about 49.8%. These are the procedures, a rough statistical figure. So you start by applying for a DIN number, which you can do it online. I've also put the associated costs here. So as you can see, this is all payable online. You don't have to go anywhere except for getting it authenticated from a CA or CS or cost work accountant. So you're not absolutely required to go anywhere. Anywhere. You have to just get it authenticated once, submit all your documents, and you can start a company of your own. You can also obtain the digital signatures online. You can reserve your name, you can check the incorporation as well. I mean, your company will be incorporated, you'll get all the details. Everything happens online. You can even register for your VAT online. You can pay your stamp duty online. You can register for the professional tax online. You can register for the medical insurance, your employees' provident fund. Everything is there. Some of the landmarks that MCA achieved. Now, MCA21, which I said was the e-filing software, it works on an Adobe platform that was activated in 2006. MCA replaced the physical stamp previously, which was required, by an online version. So now we have an e-stamping available, which was done since 2010. The online VAT registration was established in 2011. And the XBRL filings, which is the latest in the international standards for the financial statements, have also been in effect from 2012. So you can file your returns online. There are a couple of other things which, of course, a lot of entrepreneurs face, which require taking some other permits. So I've put them across. You can just have a glance through. The procedures regarding the construction permits are about 34. The time is about 196 days. Getting electricity, there are 7 procedures, around 67 days. Registering your property, never try and get away with this, because that's one asset that you'll which will keep growing and which will help you get good credit some point in time. Never do away with this part. There are 5 procedures, about 44 days. Getting credit. I'm sure any and every entrepreneur when wants to scale up or upscale for buying new machinery or anything would like to get connected to systems and investment agencies. So these could be a bank, these could be raised through JVs or equity or any procedure, but then ultimately make sure that your legal entity is in place. Protecting investors. taxes. I'm not a tax expert, so I'll refrain from adding too much on the tax. But yes, we pay multiple taxes. You can also trade across borders. You can obtain your export-import numbers. And the documents required are about 9. The time is about 16 days. Enforcing contracts. This looks horrible. You can also help get yourself out of debt. You can resolve insolvency issues. But then again, for everything, you have to be a legal entity. And until and unless you're not a legal entity, nobody can come forward and help you. So just make sure that you become a legal entity as soon as you want to even think of starting a business for yourself. So tensed or geared up, the choice is absolutely yours. You can actually become a success story someday, but just make sure your processes and your procedures and the compliances are in place. Thank you so much.